Welcome, love from love, hope from hope, and peace from peace. Amen, now and forever. And I hope it shall always evermore be. Welcome. And these are the days of Elijah, the days of Shiloh, the days of one who has come feeding the master's household meat. Christ foretold this in Matthew 24. So judge for yourself from this reading. But you are listening to the everlasting gospel that was foretold to bring forth the harvest of love. And it's time that the Lord is truly, truly doing a brand new thing. And it's a time for the great refreshing of earth, the great restitution, the great regeneration of Acts 3:21. And it is foretold that if it does not happen by love alone, that Christ is kept in reserve in heaven and cannot even return. So praise God, it's time to get along with the new program of having happy faces. We got to be like those dinos, really, sincerely. We need to have big grins across our face because these are the days for meat. Who will come and feed the master's household meat while the master is away? And man, if you're a carnivore for spiritual things, this is the channel to be at. It is the only Kingdom Age channel that will ever truly be, and it is the only one that is the Latter-day Mountain of Isaiah 2 and Micah 4, the Latter-day Mountain of meat of Isaiah 25. Upon this Latter-day Mountain, the weak will say they're strong and they'll beat their sword into the sickle. It's a change because of the distortionality of love has now finally been removed. So welcome, and know that within but a moment of a moment, anyone may transcend upon to the great white cloud where Christ stands in Revelation 14 and Matthew 24, putting his sickle into the earth. For he is revealing himself as the sower of the seed of love who has overtaken his very own reaper. So let all of the obedient children of that eternal Father, they need to come to understand that many condemnations shall proceed out of the holy lips of that glorious King of Kings over loveless people. If you're not walking with the Spirit, there is condemnation. So I urge all people that want the truest truths to press into this exciting text of the Lord's most passionate praises and his deepest fervent worship that all seekers of truth should be embracing. And they will find themselves, if they want to be edified and exhorted and lifted up so that we might mount up on eagle's wings, that it's time that we need to be raised up, and God will bear us up and upon the breath of dawn. And we can walk on the wings of the wind. And to help such children of light to be shining like our Sun of Righteousness arising, our Star of Stars, the Star of Bethlehem, it is He, our Majesty of Majesties, who is shining His glory of His love, because He is smiling over all of us in silence, even over those who have not yet come forth. But blessed are the wise souls, and let their most peaceful love begin flowing as a mighty river within us, so that they don't have to cling onto all unloving emotions. It's time to, the captive must be set free. And for that cause, Jesus says to all of his faithful few by his Spirit of prophecy that he has chosen them, like one from 1,000 and like two from 10,000, and yet under their shadow of peace, they will all be standing as a single one. And his Spirit of unity had to reveal this so that they could behold the foretold place where that carpenter of the ages is, for the holy ground where that majesty of majesties stands tall and proud. It is also his most hallowed grounds of his very own adoration for everyone born of love, all the children of God. And they must seek first the kingdom of God and seek it, that kingdom of peace, so all other things can finally be added unto them. Therefore, his Spirit of Truth is now declaring that anyone with two ears had better listen to his Spirit as he reveals his everlasting gospel truth, that there is always inner light within all people of love's brightest light of glory, and it shines from within us unto the whole world. But if we hide that glorious light of his very best charity and good wishes for all, it can never shine at all, and then they become as dark as they slowly let their love wax cold, while becoming so desensitized that they instead begin embracing the destructive kind of unloving attitudes that causes fools to commit the unforgivable sin of spiritual suicide, letting their love light go out. So blessed are all those mourning our loveless world, for their love shall transform it into a world of God's adoration that's flowing mightily as a great ocean of the magnificence of love's most radiant beneficence. And for that cause, our Lord once said to the multitudes that they should all love their friends like their own souls, and that they should be protecting those that they love as like we guard the pupil of our eyes. And it's also gospel truth that if any of them, he told them, if they see a sliver in their friend's eye, but not the log in their own, when they finally take it out of their own eye, they'd finally be able to see well enough to help their friends to remove any slivers from their eyes. And it is time that the wise need to know that they do not fast, the wise do not fast from the unloving world around us. Instead, we could never find the Father's kingdom of faith, hope, and love if we were to block ourselves. So blessed are all those true unto themselves, for they freely admit that if they take away their love, that earth would only become a tomb, a barren and desolate, as is our religion, Isaiah 49:8 says so. And to them, and for that reason, such wise people of our loving Lord of always, he freely chooses to love his unconditional love to the greatest possible depth, because his love is bottomless. There has never been any divine love on planet Earth unless it has been unconditional. What glory is any kind of love that is full of conditions and condemnation and judgment? So know that to the greatest possible depth, breadth, and height, we should allow love to invade our souls so that we can reach for the Lord's unending glory. And as we reach for the Star of Stars, our Star of Bethlehem, it's know that he's closer than you think. There's already footsteps on the moon, and that's for sure. And due to such crystal truths, Isa Yeshua once declared that in the spirit of hope, he takes his stand in the midst of the world. But he warned that if he appeared to most people, he would only find them hopelessly drunk by bitter attitudes that in turn causes them to never be spiritually thirsty at all. They think they're full, and they're full of delusions. And he added that his soul aches for the children of humanity because they are all mostly blind in their hearts, and they do not see, for they came into the world empty, and they also seek to depart from the world empty just as they came. So blessed are all those inheriting the kingdom of love, for their adoration becomes ablaze with the most glorious fires of God's most tender mercies that he's pouring out in these days. And it is written in Jeremiah 30:24, it shall be considered in the latter days this, that God says, I will be the God of Israel from all families of Israel, from the least to the greatest, and all mankind. For the Lord says, I am the Lord God of all mankind. And the covenant has always been given to all wrongly, because it was always written for all. So he therefore says to all of his people, as he pours out his spirit of love upon them, he says, I will be your God, you will be my people, I will forgive your iniquity, I will never remember it, I will write my law and my love upon your hearts, and beyond that, never, no one will ever even need to be taught of me anymore. Once you know that he's unconditional love, he says, all shall know me, from the least to the greatest. And all of us as children have had our love alive. So be as children again. Be born again by the Spirit. And for that cause, Christ is now declaring to his faithful few that their flesh came into being because of Spirit. And such is a true marvel of marvels, part of the mystery of God. So let all the loveless now marvel at how such great wealth thoughtlessly dwell in poverty by the refusal to press into deeper truths, by the spirit of ignorance that they mostly embraced like it was their pillows. So blessed are the intelligent who won't be foolish, who lets their life take its most forgiving course, since they only want to keep moving forward, so they won't tie themselves down to moments that are already over. And so many people have anchored themselves in a bad place, and it's time that we must get along and we must leave the safety of the shores. Christ Jesus is the deep who's calling unto deep. And he is the treasure of excellence and the excellence of treasure. So come out away with me and know that it is most true that the wind of his blessedness is with us, and the tide of new understandings can be yours if only you will have ears to hear what love would really want to say to everyone. Truth.